much. Thank you. I'm so happy to be back. It's been such a long time, but I'm happy to be back.
Charles, you have to share my word. This year. Okay. Alright, so, you in Liberia, you been playing for Nema County?
Yeah,
you in Liberia. Being away, how is it like with you?
Being away, like, I've been away for a very, very long time. Like, we left for the Africans since 1993, I guess, 1993, and from there we traveled. So, we used to come. We used to go Tapeta like 93, 94, but then when we left and when I traveled abroad, I did not come back to 2 days, like till yesterday.
Yeah.
But I've always been watching D9TV. I can say D9TV is the real reason I'm here today. Plus, Charles Attackay Media Foundation. A lot of time I go on Facebook and watch Nima TV, Dina TV, and the other TV station from Liberia. So one of these days, I think it was right after Christmas, if I'm not mistaken, I was watching Dina TV. I never knew it was a Dina TV, but it just popped up. And I was watching Emma and Sis Laura in Zogui, and doing something about a girl did not have tuition to go to school, but she's smart. And the tuition was like, what, $30? $30. And I stood in my kitchen and I cried. At that time, it was right after Christmas. And I personally, I'm not rich. I worked very hard. So I have just spent like almost $2,000 on Christmas gift. And I watched this little girl just because of $25 or $30 and she cannot go to school. And I said to myself, why am I buying Christmas gift for my kids and for myself for over $2,000 and a child is there in Liberia is not going to school because of $25 or $30. So I'm going to change my life around this. My lifestyle now is a brand new lifestyle. If I even have to buy jeans for myself, I have to think twice. Because I know if I'm buying $50 jeans, someone can go to school in Liberia with that $50. I'm not saying I'm not going to buy jeans for myself. I'm going to buy jeans for myself, but my lifestyle changed totally. So I contacted Emma, and from there we start talking, and we start making arrangements for him to go. I'm personally from Tapeta. I'm from Tapeta originally, but I was born in Ba. Born in my country, my parents moved to Ban in the 70s, so I was born in Ban, and during the war, we moved back to Tapeta. So he was going to Tapeta to do some stuff for me, and by some reason, that car broke down, right, in Delta City. So he called me, I was like sleeping, he called me like 2 a.m. said, CEO, I can't go to Tapeta, there's a problem, and I have to do this right here in Delta. So he decided to sponsor three girls from Yeni school. He sponsored three girls from Yeni school. I said, you know what? It's a blessing because my husband from Gata. And for you to stop in Gata is a blessing. So stopping in Gata but also Charles Media in my life. So, yeah. And after that, we've been working together and everything been fine. I'm so happy to be here. I can't even believe I went to the Hope Orphanage and the children. Some of them even recognize me because when you go, we video chat and stuff. Mm. So I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be in Liberia as a whole.
So here, what are some of the things you're going to be doing with the little children?
This time, we're going to sponsor kids to a back to school. We call it back to school. So we're going to, people already registered for school. But some people register their kids for school, but they don't have the funding to continue, or they don't have the installment payment. They don't have the second payment or the third payment. We're going to come in and help other kids to pay for their school fees. And at the same time, we're having Christmas party for the kids, right? We're having Christmas party, and we also doing kids here on the 24th of December, which is in Gata. Going to be working with the Hope Orphanage Home to do kids here and also have Christmas party there for kids. And we have some clothes that we're going to distribute kids in Gata and as well in like all over. Like we're going to Barasa, we'll be in Kakata, and we'll be in Moroville. We're also going to Tapeta. we're actually 20.
Now, with all of what you're doing, what do you intend to benefit at the end of the day? What would be your own benefit?
My mother took care of a lot of people, and in my household, my mother had 9 kids, but in my household, we were more than 20. So there are people always around. She always helping people, sending people to school. So I saw that, and to me, helping people, I work very hard. It's not like I'm getting funding from people or I'm getting funding from other organizations. It's my hard-earned money. So helping people is a blessing to me. I'm not expecting anything back. It's just a blessing.
Okay. Jazz, could you tell us more about
activities tomorrow, Jazz Media? Yeah, for the tomorrow, we've been working for the past 2 months making some preparation for the program. Tomorrow, we sent for 20 schools. A lot of things will be happening. The culture will be performing, and then some of the students will be dancing, especially from the House of Wheelchair Recovery and Singapore Catholic School, or mentoring all of the high schools in contact of the Kidney Daycare School. They all will be there to showcase themselves, to say everybody is somebody. It doesn't matter where you're from, or how you're looking, or how things like. You can become a president, you can become a minister, you can become a director you want to be. So we're doing this primary to bring everyone together to make Liberia one, to make things happen. So the future is bright and everything will be great.
So, like, we are all one, no matter the situation. So we treat, I personally treat everybody the same. Even if they are orphan or they have parents or they live at home. I feel very sad, but I think everybody is the same. I treat everybody the same.
Would there be any plan where you will make more contacts on the side to help the children of today? You will be meeting and also tomorrow?
Well, yeah, I've been doing that from day one I met Emma, and when I came in contact with Charles, I've been asking people for help. Right now, there's no help, it's fine, but I believe in God, there will be a help. I have a girlfriend at work named Faith Mondiara. She's been helping me financially sometime, and she's a good friend to me. And I pray that people will come around and help me. I keep on posting on my Facebook page and also on my Instagram, but now people don't take you seriously. Like, people think I'm wasting my time. Let me say that. Like, people think I'm really wasting my time by putting my time into kids or coming to Liberia, helping kids, or working hard, like working 16 hours and putting money aside to help kids in Liberia. They think I'm wasting my time, but I think I'm not wasting my time at all. I think those kids will be our future tomorrow, so we have to invest in them. Let's come together and help our children. Our children, they are our future for tomorrow. So when someone is doing something, like this little thing like foundation or fundraising, $1 will make a difference. Let's put money together and help our children. Let's send our children to school, at least to keep them from the streets. Please. That's not everything.